Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome to Repair and Replace. Refrigerators come in three main configurations. This includes top freezer, bottom freezer, and side-by-side models. It doesn't matter which type you have, all refrigerators have a cooling circuit and a defrost circuit. They will also have a control board or a cold control thermostat. Depending on the model, the thermostat or thermistor monitors the temperature inside the fridge. When cooling is needed, the cold control sends power to the cooling circuit. The compressor pushes the refrigerant through the system. In the freezer, heat is extracted by the evaporator coils and is released through the condenser coils behind the refrigerator. This process continues until the set temperature is reached. Now that you know the basics, we can take a closer look at these systems. This can help you troubleshoot some of the common problems. In this episode, first we'll learn how the heat transfer works. Then we'll look at the airflow. Finally, we'll learn more about the defrost system. To understand how a refrigerant works, you'll have to understand the relationship between temperature, energy, and the different states of matter. When a liquid is hot enough, it evaporates into a gas. It absorbs energy, but does not change temperature. The reverse is also true. When a gas condenses into a liquid, it releases energy. It's these phase changes that allow the refrigerator to transfer heat. The sealed system is filled with a special refrigerant, which is a liquid that can be easily boiled into a vapor and condensed into a liquid, over and over again. The refrigerants R134A and R600 have a respective boiling point of minus 26 and minus 11 degrees Celsius, which makes them highly effective. During a cooling cycle, the compressor changes the refrigerant into a high-pressure, high-temperature vapor. Next, the refrigerant is pushed through the condenser coils. As the fan circulates air over the coils, heat is released, and the gas condenses into a high-pressure liquid. The refrigerant next passes through a capillary tube. This restricts the flow, causing the pressure and temperature to drop. The liquid now flows through the evaporator coils. A fan inside the freezer circulates air over top of the coils. The heat is absorbed as the refrigerant evaporates into a gas. It is now a low-pressure, low-temperature gas and flows back to the compressor. This process continues as heat is released through the condenser coils. To work properly, there needs to be proper airflow inside and outside the refrigerator. The condenser fan circulates air over the condenser coils. If the fan is faulty, or if the coils are covered in dust, then it will reduce the heat transfer. The evaporator fan circulates air over the evaporator coils and into the fridge compartment. If the fan stops running, or if the coils are full of ice, then less heat will be extracted. Alternatively, any blockage of the vents between the fridge and freezer sections will also prevent air from circulating. In any case, you might notice that the fridge is too warm or that the compressor is running more frequently. You can see how to troubleshoot these problems in the videos linked below. Each time the door is opened, humid air enters the fridge. This moisture condenses and freezes around the evaporator coils. If left unchecked, a buildup of ice will prevent the refrigerator from cooling properly. Modern refrigerators have a defrost system. This includes a defrost timer or controller, a heating element, and a thermostat or thermistor. When the cycle begins, the defrost control shuts off power to the compressor and the fans. This prevents the refrigerator from cooling while the heater is active. Next, power is sent to the heating element, which melts the ice on the coils. The water flows into the drain pan under the fridge and evaporates over time. The heating element continues to heat until the defrost thermostat warms up and disconnects power. Once the time is up, power switches back to the cooling circuit. If the system is stuck in the defrost mode, then it will prevent the compressor from running. Alternatively, if any defrost component fails, then ice will build up and the system will not cool properly. You can see how to troubleshoot the defrost system in the video linked below. If you like this and want to see more tutorials and informational videos, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.